I'm not upset at anybody, at any people. I'm not upset at people. You know, the Holy Ghost told me people can't come out of what they can't see. So I'm not, you know, I'm not upset at people. I love people. I really do. I love hanging out with people, talking to people, being around people, as long as it's not too many people. But there's a devil loose. You and I have an assignment to be salt. Is that right? You know, you don't just eat gobs of salt. Salt brings flavor. We bring flavor to society. To bring light. Well, you never know there was light without darkness. You know, in painting, the Impressionist, they transition art to a whole different level because they discovered that color comes from light. So if you look before the Impressionists, all you saw was dark and light paintings, you know, but you never saw color and the color and light. I mean, they transformed art because of their discoveries of color. Amen? Because of light. Well, you and I are light in a society that needs light. Amen? We're also called to be a city on a hill. What does that mean? That means you're visible. Well, I don't want to be visible. I'm hiding. You chicken. And because people hide, because they're trying to get out of here, listen, this is why we have to have not just pastoral-only churches, but we have to have apostolic churches that equip people to be light, that equip them for the battle, the opposition they're going to get. Amen. You know, this is, see, people don't want it. People have that Rodney King spirit. Can't we all just get along? I wish we could. But we can't all just get along. Somebody's got to say something. That job that belonged to the preacher, that job belongs to all of us. It's the ministry that God has given to all of us to endure hardship like a good soldier. You know, Jesus is captain of the army. Amen. The Lord of hosts is his name. Our God is a warrior. He's not a baby in a manger, folks. He's a warrior. You know, when Jesus came along, listen, before Jesus got here, the kingdom belonged to the devil. But then Jesus comes up, what does he do? He reconstitutes the kingdom of God right here on the earth. It's not on the other side of Pluto. It's right here, right now. But with you and I, we have to fight for that. Amen. Every generation has to fight. Take the keys that God gave them and use those keys. The sword of the Spirit. God has given us an anointing to battle with. Amen. See, we have reduced the anointing to nothing but blessing, 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 blessing. We bring everybody to the guy with the white suit on so he can blow on everybody. But we don't recognize that the anointing God gave you so that you could establish the kingdom, advance the kingdom. Well, in the kingdom you have what? Conflict. You can't escape the conflict, folks. The only thing you can do is be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. The Apostle Paul, he said, when I come unto you, I didn't come unto you with enticing words of man's wisdom. I wasn't a good preacher. I wasn't trained to preach. I wasn't a pretty boy preacher. He said, but I came to you with the power of God. See the difference? In other words, the Holy Ghost is going to back it up. But today we have churches, they don't want the Holy Ghost. They want to be entertained. So guess what you get? You get devils running free and killing children.